Hi, and welcome to the Grumpy Old Man series.
Calisthenics is all you need.
Hans, how the hell do you know what I mean? You never asked my goals. You certainly didn't ask what joint problems and limitations I need. So how on earth can you possibly give me credible advice? You can't. One, stop assuming that everyone shares your goals. They don't. Two, stop giving ignorant and unsolicited advice. These calisthenics people are as bad as vegans and born-again Christians. Live and let live does not work for them. They want to convert the whole world to their way of thinking. Teens watch one video from a fake natty YouTuber and suddenly they're an expert on calisthenics, even though they can't even do a single pull-up. Dunning-Kruger in action. Google that. First of all, calisthenics will not make you big and muscular. If you still think this, you fell for the fake natty YouTuber who makes money by lying to you. Here are the facts about calisthenics. First, body weight exercises plus steroids equal muscles. Second, people who are under 5'6", genetically top 0.01%, under 6% body fat, have flawless nutrition, can look steroid big even though they're natural. But you know what? You are not. Unfortunately, calisthenics has been taken over and ruined by the fake natties, just like everything else. What the hell is calisthenics anyway? It's such a vague term. It's like toning exercises. What the hell is that? For clarity, before we go on, we have to divide calisthenics into two separate things. First of all, the body weight exercises that build strength but do not require coordination, balance, or skill. Things like push-ups, pull-ups, jumping squats, dips. Those are great examples of body weight exercises you can use to build muscle. Then we have the second category, the things that require incredible coordination, skill, balance, and flexibility. These are the gymnastics moves. Let's talk about each of these components of calisthenics individually. The body weight exercises, the push-ups, the pull-ups, the dips. I travel 6 to 8 weeks internationally a year. When I do body weight exercises every other day. I do push-ups, pull-ups. I bring my suspension trainer. These are awesome workouts. And for someone of intermediate or advanced bodybuilding experience like myself, they're a great way to maintain muscle mass, but you will not gain any. The only way you can gain muscle mass doing body weight exercises is if you are a total newbie with no muscle mass. For those saying I am wrong, let me repeat. Steroids plus body weight exercises equals huge muscles. Now let's talk about the gymnastics moves that a lot of people mean when they're talking about calisthenics. The bar work, the ring work, the floor exercises like backflips and things like that. These are awesome physical challenges to work toward mastery. They require incredible skill, coordination, flexibility, and balance. Having said that, they are not something that everyone should do. If you have shoulder problems, lower back problems, knee problems, these are a really bad idea. You know what? People who say everyone should do gymnastics, go to a gymnastics meet. How many people over 60 do you see on the rings? There's like one person in the whole country that you can point to. Conversely, go to a triathlon and look at the over 60 age category. A lot of times it can be like 30% of the people are in that age group. It's because running, biking, and swimming are very age-appropriate exercises, whereas gymnastics is not. It's hard on the body. So Hans, no, calisthenics is not all you need. It's not for everyone. Only beginners can build money with body weight exercises. And if you're talking about the gymnastics moves, those are great for working on coordination, flexibility, balance, but they're not going to gain you muscle. If you still think so, it's because you're believing the fake natty YouTubers who are lying to you. Thanks for watching. How Peter Zane.
Alice Clark.